CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 7.
English language lesson 3 questions part 2. Learners of class 7, welcome to the wonderful world of English language classroom. Learners, this is part 2 of the first lesson, class 7 English language, from the textbook Honeycomb, 3 questions. In the first part, learners, we learned the understanding of the text and some vocabulary. Vocabulary we also will learn here now. We understood the complete story by listening to the summary, doing some activities. Learners, with me is Sirath here.
Hello, my friends.
Fine. All right. Sirath did all the activities for you, and you also did the activities from there. We know the 3 questions. What is the right time to begin something? Which people should the king listen to? What are the most important things for him to do in life as a king, as an individual? Learners, these questions may also have disturbed you, means influenced you to some extent. Think about it. Even one another thing I asked you last time. Have you ever told a lie? You must have asked some other people, your parents, even teachers, anybody. You keep asking whether people are telling lie or not. Okay, fine. All right, learners. Today, what we do is, with Sirath, we will revisit the text again, understand the summary, then do some vocabulary and one speaking activity again. The way we did, imagining that you were the king. Now we will imagine somebody else. Come on. Before we move on to the story, learners, let me ask Sirath to tell you the objectives of this lesson. At the end of this lesson, we learners will be able to... Sirath.
Read a variety of text in English and identify main ideas, characters, sequence of ideas and events, and relates with his or her personal experiences.
Then next objective, respond to a variety of questions on familiar and unfamiliar texts verbally and in writing.
Use appropriate words to deduce meaning for clues in the context while reading a variety of texts.
Okay, we will use the words appropriately to deduce meaning, means to infer meaning, to understand the meaning, and use the words. And speak in English using appropriate expressions and ideas. Fine. All right. Learners, let's take you back to the story once again. So, because you may not have forgotten, but it's kind of refreshing your memory of the story. Come on. We will read alternatively, myself and Sirath. Once there was a king who had 3 questions in his mind. He wished to know the answers to the questions to be a successful ruler.
The 3 questions are, 1. What is the right time to begin something? 2. Which people should he listen to? 3. What are the most important things for him to do?
Remember, learners, the 3 questions. To find answers to the questions, the king sent his messengers throughout his kingdom, and he even announced a reward for the convincing answers.
The king was not satisfied with the answers, so he decided to seek the advice of a hermit.
So what happened? His minister said something. You consult a magician. Magician will do wonder and give an answer. So he was not happy. So what he did was, he decided to visit a hermit in the jungle. So he visited the hermit. The hermit listened to the king but did not speak a word, and went on digging the ground which he was digging.
He visited the hermit in the jungle. The hermit was listening to the king but not speak a word, and went on digging. The king continued digging the ground till evening.
Okay, the king sought to help the hermit and he continued. A man came running towards the hermit and the king with a wound on his stomach.
The king cleaned the wound and dressed it twice to control the flow of blood.
In the morning, when the king woke up, he saw the man, the wounded man, was seeking for forgiveness, touching the king's feet.
The king went to look for the hermit who was sowing the seeds in the bed that they had dug before.
The king begged the hermit, "Please answer my question." The hermit replied that the king had already been answered.
The hermit said that the most important time is now. The most important person at the particular moment is ourselves, and the most important thing to do is to good for others.
Learners and Sirath, the king has actually been given an experience to understand the to get the answers of his questions. So the king till the end was confused why the hermit was not answering me. So this is how learners, we also learn to get the answers. We also find answers to some of the questions through our experience. So Sirath said she wanted to know the answer to the question, how does the light works? From where does the light come? So she should seek the answer with his physics teacher by reading. So you also may have some scientific questions. You also may have some other questions like why people suffer. Buddha had that great question. What is the reason for people suffering? So he went on meditation and thinking. Then he found an answer. We know that. So desire is the root cause of all sufferings. So then the great philosophy and religion came into being. So learners, you must ask questions to your teachers, parents. Come on, that is the summary of the story, Sirath and the learners. We will learn some vocabulary, but it's very interesting. English language, or many languages, have this peculiar and very interesting usage. The same word is used as verb as well as noun. So let me give an example, learners. From there, we will learn how the same word is used as a noun as well as verb. Okay, come on, listen to it carefully. He promised me to help during my trouble. He has kept his promise. Sirath?
Yes, sir.
Look at the two sentences I'm saying. He promised to help me during my trouble. He has kept his promise. Look at the use of the word promised in the first. He promised me to help. Then he has kept his promise. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So, first one, he promised to help is verb. In the next one, he has kept his promise is a noun. The promise I gave to people means promise is a noun. I promise people to help. Second, I promise here is verb. Okay, come on, let's see. I'm going to read out some more sentences for you where the same word used as verb as well as noun. Don't judge people by appearance. The judge delivered the judgment. Don't judge people by appearance. The judge delivered the judgment. Don't judge people. There it is, verb. Then the judge delivered the judgment. Noun.
It's a noun.
Noun. So look at the third one. The king was expecting answer from the hermit, but the hermit did not answer. Look at answers, answer, answer. The king was expecting answers from the hermit. The king was expecting answer from the hermit, but the hermit did not answer. The first one, look at Sirath. The king was expecting answer from the hermit. Answer here is?
Answer here
noun.
Is noun.
Noun.
And answers is?
Next time answer is, he did not answer is verb. Verb, okay. Now, learners, let me repeat the sentences. Three sentences I have said. He promised me to during my trouble. He has kept his promise. He promised me during the trouble. He has kept his promise. He promised me, promised is verb. He kept his promise is noun. Okay. Don't judge people by appearance. The judge delivered his judgment. So don't judge is verb. Then the judge delivered is?
Noun.
Noun. Okay. The king was expecting answer from the hermit. Noun or verb? The king was expecting answer from the hermit.
Noun.
Answer here is noun. But the hermit did not answer here.
Is verb.
Verb. Because he did not answer. Doing an action. Okay. Now, I am going to read out sentences. You have to use the same word as verb as well as noun. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Learners and Sirat, ready?
Yes, sir.
We will do some activities. I have read out how the word promise is used as both as verb as well as noun. Then answers. The king was expecting answer from the hermit, but the hermit did not answer. The same way, I'm going to ask you to use the same word as a noun as well as the verb. Come on. Sirat, ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Come on, let me read the first sentence. You have to use the word judge here as a noun as well as the verb. You dash the problem correct, then you are a good dash.
You judge the problem correct, you are a good judge.
Say it again.
You judge the problem correct, you are a good judge.
You judge the problem correct, you are a good judge. First it is verb or noun?
It's.
First is?
Verb and the second one is noun.
Okay, when you say you judge the problem correct, you are doing the judgment, so it is a verb. You judge the problem correct, you are a good judge. You are a good judge, that's a name, noun. Then now let's look at the second word. The committee dash to take dash by tomorrow. Use the word decide. The committee
decide.
Dash to take dash by tomorrow. Come on.
The committee decided to take decision tomorrow.
Fine. So there's a difference here. Decide and decision. The committee decided to take a decision by tomorrow. Fine. One is verb or another is noun. Come on. Let me tell you, here you have to use the word answer both as noun as well as verb. Don't dash the questions now. Your dash should not be long.
Don't answer the questions now. Your answer should be not long.
Should not be long.
Should not
Come on,
be
say
long.
It again.
Don't answer the questions now. Your answer should not be long.
Okay. Which is the verb, which is the noun? Don't answer the question.
Don't answer the question is
verb.
Verb and the
Your answer
should be not long is the noun.
Noun. Okay. Don't answer the questions now. Your answer should not be long. So don't answer is verb. Your answer should not be long. There it is noun. Come on. Let's do one more thing. Yeah, dash is the one who dash people's actions. Yeah.
A judge is the one who judges people's actions.
A judge is the one who judges people's action. A judge is noun, is it?
Yes, sir.
Who judges is verb.
Verb.
Okay. Then, next one. A dash is the one who dash the patient.
A nurse is the one who nurses the patient.
A nurse is the one who nurses the patient. So, a nurse is?
Nurse is a noun and nurses is the verb.
Verb. Come on. The last one. He dashed the plants with a special dash of herbs.
He watered the plant with a special water for herbs.
Fine. All right. He waters the plant with a special water of herbs. He waters, verb. With
and
a special water, noun. Learners, you also try to notice this use of the same word as noun as well as verb. And you may also use it. The very, very, very nice example is he waters the plant. So, you say, sometimes you say, he gave water, he poured water. Instead of that, he watered the plant with good water, with fertilized water. Fine. Learners, Sirat, very good, well done. What we need to know and learn is in English, maybe in other languages also, we have the same word used as noun as well as verb. Come on, go back and read the lesson. You have more activities at the end of the lesson. Okay, learners,
Come on, let's move on to next one. Sirat, I know that learning vocabulary seriously and grammar is slightly not so interesting. We have to learn it and do it. Now, I'm going to ask you the way you did in the first spot. You imagined that you were the king and
yes,
answered.
Sir.
Yeah. Then, now, you are the king or hermit?
Hermit.
Last time?
No, last time I was the king.
Okay. So, you have to say, learners, what is the need for this activity and importance that you need to speak to teachers in the school and someone in the neighborhood in your language or in English. So here this makes you to practice, train yourself to how to speak to others describing something. Now imagine you are the hermit. You are the hermit. No clues will be given. I'm going to tell you some clues. You are the hermit. You are going to narrate your personal experience. You may say that yesterday or last week, I was digging the bed of the earth, the ground, to sow some seeds. Then I saw a king approaching me. Then he was asking me, he took the spade from me and started digging like that. Huh? So I'm not giving you the entire thing. Come on, Sirat, take some time, think about it, say it. For the benefit of learners, the learners, please try to do on your own. Yeah, come on.
I was digging.
No, don't start abruptly. Begin give the occasion when it was, when it happened. Okay, one day or last week, even yesterday. Come on, go ahead.
One day, I was digging some ground to sow the seeds. While I was digging, I saw a king approaching me. So he was, he asked that, answer my three questions. I have three questions and they are, what is the right time to begin something? What people should I listen to? And what is the most important person? So what is the most important thing also to do? So he said that, I didn't say anything. I didn't stop digging and I didn't say anything. I was just listening. Then I saw a man approaching to us and he was coming to us and he was wounded in his stomach. So he came near us. I saw the king and he dressed the man and I got some water to drink and then we led him to sleep and then the next day when I was sowing my seeds in the bed I had dug before so it was
the king came to me again.
Yes, the king came to me again and told me, I am begging you, please answer all my questions. So I told him, I have answered all your questions and the most important time is now. The most important person at that particular moment is we ourselves and the most important thing to do is to good for others.
So the king was convinced?
So the king was convinced and he went happily to his castle.
Good. Learners, Sirat has done without any preparation. Now I'm going to ask her to say it again. Slightly improved so that you can also do it. Come on, go ahead.
One day I was digging some soil and to sow my seeds and then I saw that the king was approaching to me and then I saw him and I continued digging. So the king took my spade and asked me, can I dig for you? You're looking very old and weak. So I asked him, okay, you can do it. So I sat and he dug the ground. So
he dug the ground.
Dug the ground. So we saw a man approaching to us and he was wounded severely in his stomach. So I saw the king was dressing him up when he came near. The king dressed him up and he was dressing him twice that his blood will stop flowing. And then I got some water to the man to drink and then we led him to sleep in the hut. So the next day when I was sowing my seeds in the place we have dug the beds we dug the day before, and so the king came to me and told me that, please, I beg to you, please answer my questions. Then I told him, you have already been answered. I was telling him that the answers are, the most important time is now, the most important person at that particular moment is we ourselves, and the most important thing to do is good to others.
Well done, well done. Okay, then what he did?
Then he was, he happily left my home.
Very good. You are also convinced. Okay, fine. Learner, this is a good thing to do in the sense, first time she said slightly with problems, the later she improved it. So the language improves. This is what we call, language happens in the brain, learners, in our mind, we process it. You have some ideas with you, then you put it into language. This is called language processing. You don't have to bother about the term, but this is what one learns language. Suppose if I ask Sirat and you to do the tell the third time, you'll say still better. Then later ask you to write it into a paragraph, you can work and write it very well. Okay, learners, thank you very much. Thank you, Sirat. Before we leave, let me give you homework. That is, Sirat, you have narrated the experiences of in part one the king, is it?
Yes, sir.
Then later the hermit. So you may choose one of the two and write it into a paragraph, two paragraphs.
Okay,
so the same first person narration as you speak,
yes,
narrate. So if you choose to write the king's narration, king's speech, means king, what king speaks, you say it, I wanted to know the answers of my three questions which were in my mind for a long time. Like that, you start in first person. The same way hermit, one day I was digging the ground, bed of the earth to sow some seeds. I saw a man coming towards me. So learners and Sirat, that this time you have, when you write, you have a lot of luxury of time. You have time. So what you do is, you write, you put the draft, first the pointers, outline, then write the draft. Means before writing, gather all your points. Okay, learners, thank you very much. Thank you, Sirat, for having participated actively in the class 7 lesson, three questions. Now, we will meet you in some other lesson the next time. Thank you very much. Keep learning, keep reading. And I would like to give you a piece of advice or suggestion. Keep reading newspaper every day, at least for 10-20 minutes, whichever newspaper item interests you. It may be sports, politics, jokes, some cartoons come at the end of the newspaper. You read anything, not only in English or your language, not only in English, any language you get. Come on, otherwise, listen to the radio or television news. Have a nice time, learners. Thank you very much. Thank you, Sirat.
Thank you, sir.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.